I recently got a new branding client, so I figured what better way than to show you how I work by showing you how I work. I'm excited to take you all along. So far, we have done the brand strategy, and today I'm going to work a little bit on developing the creative direction for it. So I will be sharing my screen, showing you how it works. Yeah, just taking you through everything. So let's do it. So before I start digging into design concepts and what a project can look like visually, my process always starts with some sort of strategy, whether it's just a questionnaire to see the design direction, or if the client really wants to dig into strategy and talk more about their mission and their vision and how they want to position their business and like do a whole workshop. Either way, before I do any sort of design direction, I like to gather some sort of information to learn more about the client and their needs and who they want to market themselves to. So I will show you a quick overview of that, and then I will just get into coming up with some design directions for it. I'm still working these out, but these are the general design directions I'm thinking of after taking all of these pictures and all of these inspiration points. I'm leaning towards these three. This is more of a bold, creative entrepreneur one. This is more of a calming, I'm here for you entrepreneur creative that struggles with money vibe, and this is more of like a fun, I'm here for you as a friend to support you creative direction. So this is where I'm at right now. I'm feeling pretty happy. I just want to go back in and add more information about what I'm thinking the patterns could be. I think this is definitely more organic shapes. This one is more fun pops. So that is where I'm at right now. All right, back with more selfie action. Today I am working on my client's branding project. So I think the last video I recorded, I was sending over the creative direction and it has been approved. So the next steps are to actually get in and start designing and working on her logo. And that is what I'm working on and what I'm gonna show you.
I've done quite a few sketches of some ideas I have. I'm definitely not the strongest sketcher, but I do just like to write things out, to just think about things in my head. So these are some of the ideas I was thinking. As far as fonts, I definitely am going for a serif font that's a little bit feminine, a little flowy, a little curvy, a little angular, and these are the top three that I've liked after narrowing it down from all of the other ones that I was looking at before. So now that I found the fonts that I like, I will play around with this a bit. I might play with the shapes. I might just play with straight, regular versus italicized and add in a sans serif as well. And then I will go back to my sketches to see how I can incorporate my ideas. I'm either thinking maybe trying to play with the letters to make one of them an exclamation mark, or finding a way to combine the letters here. Her business is ACT Now Financial Services, and ACT also stands for it's an acronym. So I want to find a way to bring attention to this word since it also does stand for something. And that was my general idea when I was just kind of sketching through ideas, was finding a way to make this more unique. I kind of like the idea of it being all caps and sort of like, I guess, ghosty. Yeah, so that's what I've been thinking. And now I'm just gonna get into the computer and get started. Here is
a little bit of the chaos that happens on my board. In Illustrator, when I am starting out designing a brand, over here is where I was typing out all the fonts and just kind of seeing how they would work. And then this is where I started playing more with what it could look like. And then over here is where, when my ideas started getting a little bit more finalized, I was narrowing it down to the different letter styles, and then as well as what the logo variations could look like. Ultimately, I went with this one and then this one here. And this has an in that is pushed down a little bit more to act as an exclamation mark to really emphasize the act now of her brand name. And also act is an acronym, so I wanted to bring more attention to that because that is important to her. It stands for accounting, consulting, and taxes. And then down here, I just started kind of playing with the marks. I'm not like set on any of these yet. They are very unpolished. I kind of wanted to see what overlapping colors could look like, what this exclamation mark could look like, but that's the next step in the process. From here, I then put the final choices in another file just so it isn't as cluttered. And then I start playing with what the colors could look like or what the logo might look like on different backgrounds. And so this is still a working file, but it's a little bit more organized. And so after this, I packaged this all in a nice presentation for her with some mock-ups, and I am waiting for her approval. The next steps after this is that I put this all into a nice presentation to send over to her. I also did a screen recording to explain a little bit more about my design decisions and how it can work in different ways. And it also includes a quick little website mock-up just to show her what all of the combinations can look like together. So from this, she will choose one design direction from the two that I sent, and then I will work to refine that one that she chooses. And then after that, I will start designing all of the other logo variations, and then those will get approved. And then I just wrap it all up and export all the files, and then I'll send it over to her. And then I'm trying to remember my steps right now. After that, once that's all done, I'll then create a set of brand guidelines for her. That way she can reference it and know exactly how to use all of her brand elements. Not all clients ask for brand guidelines, but because she wants to implement everything herself and make sure she is, you know, implementing it in a way that is strong, she wanted brand guidelines for that. And I usually recommend them, but not everyone asks for them. So that's what we're doing next. I have just finished the round of revisions for my client. I sent off the original concept the last time I made a video, and she had some feedback. And so I took her feedback and we talked through it a bit about just her name and her goals and a few other things. And we decided to enlarge a bit of it and just modify. So I wanted to show you my updates and what I'm sending off to her now. The next step is for her to choose between the original one or the updated logo options. And then from there, I will create all of the different files for it and then package it up and send it to her and then work on her brand guidelines. This was the original concept I sent over to her, and her feedback was mostly that she would like for financial services to be larger versus mostly primarily focusing on the act now. In the second round, I slightly modified the exclamation point that I had made to make it shorter. That way I could enlarge financial services, but still keep act now as the main like focal point. But I do think that this solution works well and it enlarges it without overpowering the enlargement. And then here is the horizontal version of it. So I sent her a stacked version and a horizontal version. Next, I also sent her a few variations that I thought would work well. So I sent these four off. I imagine her using these maybe on social media, maybe on Pinterest, but there are just other options for her to be able to utilize her logo. And then I also created these little accent items. They look like little stickers to me, but I imagine her using these either on her website when she's talking about specific services or packages, or in this example mock-up that I put here where she could use it if she's talking specifically about a topic, and then she could also incorporate one of the other elements or even one of her other logos. I also did these mock-ups just to show what it might look like on her website with her logo and then her type suites. And then the other items I added were just these different type suite options. All three of them are a little bit different, but they all have the sans serif going on. I had sent her two options before, and this was the configuration she liked. So then I just went and found a couple of other options that I thought worked well. So that is what I sent her. And the next step is that I put that all in a presentation for her, and she will just need to choose between the original logo concept and the new one, as well as choosing the type suite that she likes. And that's about it for this project. After that, I will create a brand strategy and style guide for her to refer to, and then package all of those files for her in different colorways. I can also do a little bit of video of that, and then we will get on a call just to talk through anything, answer any final questions, and I will get her feedback. This has been a pretty smooth project, and I've definitely enjoyed working with her. And I hope that showing you my process gives you a little glimpse into what it's like to work together. Designers all have different processes, but this is one that I found to work well for me, and I hope that's helpful.
Hey, now that we are in the home stretch of this branding process, I wanted to provide an update on the last steps. So we spent a little bit more time digging into what the color palette would be, as well as refining the logo a little bit more, but we finalized the logo and the color palette, and now I am just going to work on preparing all of the final files, super excited, as well as creating a really comprehensive strategy and brand style guide for my client. That way she has a document where she can look back on everything that we discussed from the beginning of the project and how we are positioning her business moving forward, to how to use the logo, how to use the color combinations and the fonts, just so she has it there and she can always refer back to it. So that's what I'm working on now. Then yeah, I'm wrapping it up and I'm sending it all out, and then we will get on a final call for any questions and to go over everything. That is my process. Lots of selfie videos. I think I just really like holding the phone while I'm talking, but yeah, I hope this has been really helpful. Thanks so much for following along as I designed this brand from strategy to sketches to the end. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, definitely let me know in the comments. Was this process video helpful? If so, I will definitely continue to record my projects from beginning to end. That way you can see what it's like to work together, as well as my design decisions during the process. Also, if you want to stay updated, be sure to subscribe and press the notification bell for when I put out more videos. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I will talk with you soon.